work today on elastic shape from template with spatially sparse deforming forces. So before saying why we address this priority as a sparsity, I would like to tell you what's about shape from template, which is a problem to infer a 3D reconstruction of 3D shape from its 2D projection. So any alien 3D shape can project on this 2D projection. So to avoid ambiguity, we need to have more points. If we have a template shape of n points represented by nodes that get deformed in some 3D shape, so we assume that the displacement is linearly dependent on the deforming force, which has some support. We denote Q this support. K is the metric that encodes the physics of the deformation. So if this matrix K has some kernel, this kernel will represent the set of rigid displacements. Per formula L2-norm formulations minimize the force, the L2-norm of the force subject to the reprojection and boundary constraints. In presence of noise, this the recovered force won't be sparse, so because of the noise that affect the L2-norm. In our contribution, we replace the L2-norm by L1 by L0 minimization, subject to the reprojection and to the fact that the force must lie on the span of K. The problem is that the L0 norm is NP hard to solve, so we relax this problem by minimizing the L1 of the force. And we drop the constraint over the span of K.
We define as well the projective elastic space property, which states that if we have a pure elastic deformation that lies on the same image plane as on a rigid elastic deformation. And we state a first theorem saying that if this projective elastic space property is filled, then we are able to recover both the ground truth force and the ground truth rigid placement of the non-rigid object on the image. We further push this result and show that if we don't have, we have only the size of the support, we can still recover the ground truth. So we ran some simulation results on varying image noise and varying size of the support of the force, and we show that our approach performs better. Still, without the boundary constraints, we have some loss of accuracy on the boundaries, but the shape still is good. We have some experimental results on Rubbermaid material, where we have reconstructed two creases, and we see that the support is actually well recovered. We have a heel deformation on cloth, on stretchy cloth, where we see that we have the deformation well localized. We localize as well the deformations on silicone materials. We can use this approach as well to reconstruct 3D shapes on organs to use some augmented reality. So before I leave, I would like to announce our company working on some AR toolkits, and we are hiring, so welcome.